Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh teman-teman semuanya. Selamat datang di Jembatan Dakwah ya. Dan kali ini kita akan nontonin video dari Muhammad Ali lagi. Gak ada besar-besarnya kita nontonin videonya Muhammad Ali. Dan kali ini ada seseorang yang beragama lain kemudian datang ke acaranya Muhammad Ali untuk mengatakan sesuatu yang emosional. Dan intinya sih seperti menghambur-hamburkan waktunya Muhammad Ali aja sih, tapi Muhammad Ali sepertinya merasa sedikit jengkel sepertinya ya, sedikit jengkel. Tapi apa yang membuat dia jengkel? Simak video ini selengkapnya hingga akhir agar kalian tidak salah paham. Selamat menonton dan semoga bermanfaat. Mari kita react.
Matthew, how are you?
What's up, my man? Nice to meet you, bro.
Okay.
How did you like come into your beliefs, like?
That's a long story. It's essentially studying Islam properly, and then essentially studying other religions, whatever there that can claim to be a competition. But it was after studying Islam and knowing Islam is the truth first. I then said, okay, let me see why those other people believe what they believe. What is the reasoning? What are their evidences? Because I wanted to call them to the truth after knowing is the truth. So I had to also know what they believe themselves. And then I realized the more I researched the other religions, you know, why they are false.
Cool, man. So I'm just gonna share about like myself a little bit. I grew up in like a church, and it was like a Catholic church, and I always believed in God. I believed in Jesus, but I never felt God's like power in that church. And then I kind of got out of it, and I started doing like a bunch of bad stuff, like doing like smoking things and like selling them, doing a bunch of bad stuff. And I really wanted to stop, but I couldn't stop by myself, bro. Like, I just could not stop by myself, and I really wanted to. And then I cried out to the Lord. I was like, crying, I was like, please, like, I need your help. Like, deliver me from this. I can't do it on my own strength. And then he sent like some people like in my way that kind of gave me like some good tips. Like, it was my girlfriend. She told me, God made no temptation too strong that you can't overcome it. And then right when she said that, and it clicked in my mind, I was like, that's true. Like, I don't have to go outside and smoke. I don't have to go do these things. So then I stopped doing all that stuff, right? And then I got like a really close relationship with the Lord. And I left that church because in the Catholic church, it's a lot of false stuff, like worshiping like idols, like you were talking about before, like worshiping like Mary. Like, you don't worship Mary. We worship the one true God. And I went to this other kind of church event, right? And everybody's praising Jesus. We're like this, worshiping with our hands up. Nobody cares, right? As I'm worshiping, my whole body starts to tremble and shake, bro. And I just feel the love of God, like the Holy Spirit just in my whole body, bro, like 100%. And I start to pray, and it's called like tongues. That's not even me praying. It's just blowing out of my mouth, bro. I can't stop. It's just coming from my mouth. And that moment, you feel like the true love of God, bro. And like, he really loves us so much beyond all measure, bro. And like, a lot of people that we go to like things of the world, like smoking weed, like alcohol, like having sex and stuff. But that gives us like a temporary satisfaction for that 1 second. But then after that, we got to keep going back to it. But when you have Jesus in your heart and you have the Holy Spirit, bro, it's a full peace, like the peace that surpasses all understanding, bro. That just guards your heart and your mind. That you don't, obviously, like some bad thoughts, like you'll have like the enemy will like attack you a little bit, but you have your faith, bro, and that's the most important part. So I just wanted to share that, brother. Thanks for letting me share, bro.
Okay, so let me get this straight, and then you just confirm or deny. You're miserable. You're doing all of these degenerate acts, right?
Kinda, yeah.
Before Christianity, yeah. And then you met some people. You went to the church. You started shaking and speaking in tongues, and therefore Christianity is true.
Well, that's not really what I was saying. No.
So which part did I say that does not agree with what you said?
So, well, first of all, God answered my prayers. The effectual and fervent prayer of a righteous person always prevails, bro. And
you didn't mention that before.
And I, say again?
You didn't mention that before. I just said what you said, and then you said to me is wrong. So which thing I said?
No, I didn't say it was wrong. But I don't want, bro. This, I didn't come into it just to have like a debate. Like, I don't want to debate with you, bro.
I'm not debating. I'm just making sure I said what you said. All I'm doing is just clarify, because it took you some time. But I'm just summarizing it for the people.
Yes,
what
the Holy Spirit filled me, bro. The Holy Spirit filled me.
Yeah. So what you said is you had the degeneracy, blah blah blah. You met some Christians, then. What happened is you went to the church, you started shaking, the Holy Spirit filled you, mumbling with tongues or saying different things with language that no one understands, and then Christianity is true. And then Christianity is true.
Amen, bro. I follow the word of God, because in the word it says Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life, and no one goes to the Father except the I have it written on my wall. I want to just read this whole
So,
thing.
Jesus, no, no, no. I allowed you to mention your story. No? It's not a monologue, right? So now you're going to read something else. Like, it's not fair. It's a conversation. It's not a monologue. Yeah, so Jesus is the way to what?
Amen. He's the only way to heaven, bro. No one goes.
The way to what? Doesn't say to heaven in the verses you quoted.
Yeah, I'll read the verse one more time. Can I read the verse?
You don't
one
memorize
more?
It, yeah? Mm. You don't know it.
No, I do, but
I'm the way, I'm the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father, not heaven, because you misrepresent the Father. Yeah.
So then Jesus is not God because you go to the Father. He's just a way for you to get to God. He's not God.
Okay, so it says also.
No. Also, what? Also, let's just take the wrong verse. You're going somewhere else.
Yeah, no, I was answering what you said.
Yeah, the same verse. Don't go somewhere else.
No, I was gonna use what you said. So it says, "In the beginning there was the Word, and the Word was
another verse.
The Word
Matthew,
was with
Matthew,
God."
Matthew, I'm speaking English. Matthew, you quoted a verse.
Okay.
Says that Jesus is the way to God, therefore he cannot be God because he is the way to God.
So the destination is different than the way. So by the admission of the verse that you provided is evidence that this is not God. Thank you. I completely agree with that verse. Okay. I'll give you a stamp of approval. Look. Stamp of approval.
Thank you,
there
bro.
You go. Okay. I'll let you go, Matthew. Thank you for sharing.
Sorry? I got you. So it says, in the beginning...
Why you got me with what? You got me with what? I said I'll let you go.
You don't want to stay with me? I don't think you're sincere. I think you've made up your mind already. Let me ask you this. What would change you from Christianity to any other faith?
Is that like why? Is that the point of this channel? To like...
I asked you a question. Nothing would change you. Do you agree with me?
Amen. Never, bro.
That's it. Halas, you're not open-minded. So why would I say time talking to you?
No, I'm not.
Look, Matthew. Let me tell you why I'm not going to talk to you. Okay. And the reason why I said I'm not going to talk to you.
Yeah.
You come with the same story that every Christian comes with.
Okay.
Every Christian comes with. You can go to my videos and see that. All of them come with the same story. You know? They sit
in a gathering and look, this is our story, guys. Rehearse the following. And then they come with it. So... it's an emotional reason to accept something.
And you're claiming nothing will ever remove you from that emotional belief of yours. And look, now you're even not listening. You're even showing me stories. So you're saying, and then that's why I'm going to remove you. And you're saying it's an emotional belief and nothing will ever remove you from that emotional belief. Therefore, I cannot give you reasoning to move you away from being emotional, you know? That would be me just like talking to the wall. So Matthew, I would recommend you maybe make yourself a bit open-minded. Maybe in a couple of years, you realize why this makes no sense to say I was shaking in church and I became Christian. But that's not evidence that Christianity is true. And actually, you need to actually investigate and give reasons why something is true in order for other rational human beings who have agency to accept your statement. Anyways, thank you for coming, Matthew. Pleasure talking to you.
Dan itulah tadi video dapat kami sampaikan kepada kalian semuanya. Semoga bermanfaat dan semoga mendapatkan ibroh yang bisa kalian dapatkan ya. Ada di situ. Sebenarnya kalau menurut Muhammad Ali, cerita-cerita itu adalah cerita made up story di mana seringkali Muhammad Ali menemukan cerita-cerita yang sama persis dengan orang-orang yang sebelumnya pernah bercengkrama dengan Muhammad Ali dan pernah istilahnya apa ya, pernah ikutan acara Muhammad Ali ini dan hampir mirip semuanya, inilah itulah, dan itu yang membuat Muhammad Ali sepertinya sedikit males ya nanggepin orang-orang seperti itu, karena orang-orang seperti itu tuh kalau dikasih, maksudnya diajakin berpikir logis, diajakin berpikir secara sains itu seringkali nggak masuk. Jadi cuman nggak bisa bisin waktu aja. Makanya di sini Muhammad Ali langsung mengeluarkan si penanya tadi keluar dari channelnya. Ya karena itu, karena nggak bisa bisin waktu aja. Karena kalau diajak debat serius dari debat sains itu mereka nggak mau, soalnya mereka percaya, oh ini loh sesuatu yang ilahiyah itu, karena kadang-kadang sesuatu yang ilahiyah itu tidak bisa dibuktikan dengan sains, kadang-kadang seperti itu. Ya itulah tadi, kalau teman-teman punya pendapat lain silakan tulis di kolom komentar di bawah, dan semoga kita bisa diskusi dengan baik, dengan logis dan dengan akal sehat dan dengan kepala dingin. Begitu, terima kasih telah menonton video ini hingga akhir. Sampai jumpa pada video dakwah berikutnya. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.